killed by a drunk driver, September 18, 2004. This was not the way I ever envisioned taking a part of my daughter with me for the rest of my life. I never envisioned that she would die. These are the painful parts. The hours, the days, the torture. It's not simple that someone just died, but it's the business part. This document is called a certificate of death. It's difficult for me to explain what it's like filling out a death certificate for your child. It was so difficult that it took me 5 times to fill this thing out right. The other documents. I only had 1.5 hours to write this, by the way, because this had to be published in the newspaper. But this is my daughter's obituary. Imagine sitting down, writing the obituary of someone that you love. Someone so young, only 24 years old. And I ask you, where would you begin to summarize your life? And this last document hurts as well. This is the business part. This is the bill. Somebody has to pay. Unfortunately, this represents something entirely different. This represents my daughter's college education money. I never imagined this would be the way that I would invest in my daughter's future. On September 27th, that was the day of my daughter's funeral. I told you there were 2 reasons I was here. The other reason is, you saw the picture, and I was reading my daughter's obituary from the video. As I was reading her obituary, I had to pause for a moment and get myself together again. And all of a sudden, I felt this rush of all the people that were at the funeral. I felt so responsible because they were hurting and I couldn't even do anything to help them. So standing there at the podium, I made my daughter a promise. I made her a promise to do whatever I could to keep this from happening to anybody else. Any parents, any youth, because it hurt so damn bad. And it wasn't going to stop. That's the other part. You still grieve and you still mourn. Unfortunately, throughout the years, you do heal something. On the day that I took those pictures of what was left of my daughter's car, I got this bag, which is called an evidence bag. And this, just like the death certificate, I hope that you never have your name on this, or anyone that you know about. But this is my daughter's purse. And that key to Stanley is the key to that car, that 1983 Ford Thunderbird, and what I should say was left of it. And the day I took the pictures of her car, I saw these glasses on the floorboard. now, every time I see a young female with sunglasses on, I instantly think of my daughter. And finally, this represents torture. This little piece of crap cell phone. I spent over an hour going down my daughter's address book here, calling all the contacts and notifying people over and over and over that my daughter was dead. Strangers I didn't even know. Something else I want to talk to you about, and this is things have been bothering me for a long time. And I want you to take this from me, because I feel I'm probably one of the best people who ever meet. That's against alcohol and drug-related incidents. Andres is my first child that I lost. Back in 1976, I lost my fiancé and our unborn child. I, too, was also a victim. September 16, 1978, a 17-year-old drunk driver hit me head-on and almost killed me. So there's been a long cloud about long drug-related incidents, but it wasn't until my daughter was killed that I said, enough. This has to stop. The other thing it has to stop is cell phone and texting abuse. I do not call this distraction. This is abuse. It's something you don't have to do. You have a choice. And again, take it from me. There is no difference between alcohol and drug-related incidents or cell phone and texting incidents. In reality, this will get you killed just the same. So these are the destructive choices that I talked to you about, Mr. Franklin. And imagine me, the killer, and wearing a cane on your chest for the rest of your life. Or struggling to go from being a victim to survive. And that's why I'm here today. Because I'm here for you. And I talked to your parents last night, as a matter of fact. And I told them that for these 2 days, I'm adopting. All of you, and my kids too. I take the responsibility to teach you, to help you learn the consequences through me, so that none of you ever experience it. And I also thank the opportunity for the Every 15 Minutes program. This is not an easy job. It's not an easy job to conduct this. There's a lot of people behind the back scenes, a lot of hours, a lot of agony. The parents have the difficulty. And today is my 77th 15 minutes presentation. And I didn't think of any better place that I want to be right now. Because I also know that you have a problem on May 31st. If I can do this for you, my gift to you, I want you to do something for me. I want you to make a promise to yourself and to your parents that you're going to do the right thing. You're not going to do what Mr. Franklin did to my daughter. And your parents are not going to let you go. Because this is permanent. There's no replay. It's not a video game. And the consequences are lifelong. So please remember what I said about alcohol and drug-related incidents and cell phone texting abuse. There's no difference. It's not worth your life. Thank you for the opportunity, and bless you.